I am Dr. P. Saravanan, Assistant Professor of Chemistry, King's College of Engineering, Punalkulam, Pudukkottai District. Today, we are going to discuss about desalination by reverse osmosis. It is a topic of engineering chemistry in unit number 1, water and its treatment. Desalination of brackish water. It is a process of removing common salt like sodium chloride from the water is known as desalination. The water containing dissolved salts with a peculiar salty or brackish taste is called brackish water. Depending upon the quantity of dissolved solids, water is graded as three types. One is fresh water contains below 1000 ppm of dissolved solids. And the second is brackish water contains above 1000 but below 35,000 ppm of dissolved solids. And finally, the seawater contains above 35,000 ppm of dissolved solids. The seawater and brackish water can be made available as a drinking water through desalination process. The desalination is carried out either by reverse osmosis or electrodialysis. In our syllabus, we have only reverse osmosis. In this process, when two solutions of different concentrations are separated by semi-permeable membrane, solvent or water flows from region of lower concentration to higher concentration. This process is called osmosis. The driving force in this phenomenon is called osmotic pressure. If the hydrostatic pressure in excess of osmotic pressure is applied on the higher concentration side, the solvent flow is reversed. That is, solvent flows from higher concentration to lower concentration. Here, the higher concentration means salty water. This is called reverse osmosis. Thus, in this process, the reverse osmosis pure water is separated from salt water. This process is also known as superfiltration. The membranes are used as cellulose acetate, cellulose butyrate, etc. See the diagram here. The two different concentration is separated by semi-permeable membrane. The semi-permeable membrane is a highly porous in nature. It is used to filter the any solution or water. Left side of this device, one piston is fixed. The piston is used to apply the osmotic pressure to the higher concentration. Here, higher concentration is saline water. Here, lower concentration is fresh water. Okay, while applying the osmotic pressure through by piston in the higher concentration side, in the higher concentration, that means saline water, salt water, is forced to strike the semi-permeable membrane. While striking the semi-permeable membrane, all the salty content is filtered and the pure water is delivered to the lower concentration. Finally, we can get fresh water from the lower concentration. So here, the direction from saline water to fresh water, that means higher concentration to lower concentration, is called reverse osmosis. The direction of lower concentration of and higher to higher concentration is called osmosis. Advantages of reverse osmosis. Here, the lifetime of membrane is high and it can be replaced within few minutes. It removes ionic as well as non-ionic colloidal impurities. Due to low capital cost, simplicity, low operating, this process is used for converting the seawater into drinking water. This RO method, if nowadays they are using the people, they are using in the home itself also. So many of reverse osmosis unit is there. The peoples are purchasing the RO unit. Simply they filter their water and get pure water. Okay, so this reverse osmosis is used to remove all the impurities from the water. Thank you.